Good afternoon, students. Yesterday we have learned what is draft, and today we are going to go a little bit deeper into the subject. We already know drafting means thinning out or attenuation. So today we'll learn a little bit more as to the one of the types of draft, that is mechanical draft, and how to go about calculating it. So the mechanical draft is actually, we have done it in the last semester, but again I'm just going to repeat it. Draft is equal to surface speed of output roller divided by surface speed of input roller. Now how do you calculate surface speed? It is nothing but it is a product of pi into diameter of output roller into the RPM of the output roller. Whereas if you want to calculate the surface speed of input roller, it would be pi into diameter of input roller into RPM of input roller. In short, we can write it as MD, which is mechanical draft, is equal to pi D2N2 upon pi D1N1, where D2N2 are the front roller diameter and RPM, and D1N1 are the back roller diameter and RPM respectively. So just for the sake of further understanding the calculation, I'm just going to show you this diagram, explain this diagram to you. This is a sketch of a conventional draw frame. Only the necessary important parts are being shown here. We learn the construction of the draw frame in detail in the future lectures. So here we are just showing the basic parts that are there of the draw frame. Here the right hand side is the input, and the left hand side one can is shown. This is the output. In a draw frame, basically 6 to 8 card cans are fed. They are fed through these spoons that are shown. This is nothing but stop motion. Then you can see 4 pairs of rollers here. This is the drafting system. Then the web comes out of this front roller. This is the front roller. It goes into a funnel shaped part known as a trumpet. Further on, it goes into a pair of calendar rollers, which is not visible here. But after the trumpet, whatever the material comes out of the trumpet passes through the coiler calendar roller, which helps in compacting the sliver, and that particular sliver is then coiled and neatly placed in this particular output can. So this is a simple passage of a conventional draw frame where you have 4 sets of rollers. The one nearest to the output is called as a front roller. The one next to it, the one just behind it, is called as a second roller. Second pair of rollers, this is called as a third, and this is known as the back. So let us just take a look at the gearing diagram. When we learned carding, you already know what a gearing diagram means. A gearing diagram is nothing but it shows you how the drive is passed on from the motor to all the parts of the machine. So here what we see is the motor, which will drive first via a pair of pulleys the calendar roller, which is shown here. This is the coiler calendar roller, the one which was not visible in the previous diagram, which is just below the trumpet. The next, what is shown is from the calendar roller, the drive goes to the front roller via these set of gears. Then from the same calendar roller, the drive goes to the second bottom roller, that is second pair of rollers. Then it goes to the third pair of rollers further. And the drive to the back roller is coming through a different route from the calendar roller through via these set of gears to the back roller. So now let us see how we calculate the RPM of these various parts. If we assume that the motor RPM is N, the motor RPM is n and it is 1000 RPM. So how to calculate the calendar roller RPM? It would be motor RPM into 130, which is the diameter of this motor pulley, which is the driver, and it drives this calendar roller pulley, the pulley on the calendar roller shaft. So it, and its diameter is 121. So it is n into 130 divided by 121, and both, if you observe, they both are measured in mm. So you get calendar roller RPM. Similarly, we calculate further on for front roller RPM. The front roller RPM, as we have already seen, is driven via this set of gears. So again, it starts from motor RPM into 130 divided by 121 into 44 divided by 48 into 48 divided by 30. So this is the calculation for the front roller RPM. Then we go to the second roller RPM. The drive goes like this. It goes from the calendar roller to the second roller here. So again, we start from motor RPM n. N into 130 divided by 121 into 23 divided by 77 into 71 divided by 58. So you get the second roller RPM. For the third roller RPM, again the drive comes from the motor via this, in this way. So let us see, n into 130 divided by 121 into 23 divided by 77 into 71 divided by 30 divided by 58, sorry, into 37 divided by 59 into 47 divided by 30. So this is the way the gear drive. Coming to the back roller RPM, again we start from motor. Motor in RPM n into 130 divided by 121 into 44 divided by 67 into 67 again divided by 75 into 75 divided by 52 into TDC, which is 40 teeth, divided by 114 into 44 divided by 52 into 52 divided by 54. Wheels like this, 52, are known as the carriers because they just pass the speed from this shaft to this shaft. They are just transferring the speed. And what is TDC? TDC is also known as a change pinion. That means it is a very convenient wheel for anybody, the maintenance operator, to remove this wheel and put another wheel in its place. So such a wheel is known as a change pinion, which here in this case is of 40 teeth. So the values have been calculated taking 1000 RPM as a motor speed. So you get all these values: calendar roller RPM, front roller RPM. This is the RPM, rotations per minute of all these five rollers. So now how does one calculate the drafts? For calculating the drafts, I will need the surface speed of all these rollers. So to calculate the surface speed, I will require the diameters of all these rollers. So if the diameters of the calendar roller, front roller, second, third and back roller is 5.1, 3.5, 2.5, 2.8 and 2.8 centimeters respectively, then the surface speed in centimeters per minute can be calculated as follows. Calendar roller surface speed would be pi into diameter, that is 5.1, into 1074 that we calculated in the earlier slide. So when you multiply these figures, you get these numbers for each one of them. You get the surface speed in centimeters per minute. So if I have to calculate the draft between calendar ruler and front ruler. According to the formula, it would be surface speed of calendar ruler, that which is the considered as the output ruler here, divided by surface speed of front ruler. So if you calculate this, this would be 17200 divided by 17309, which would be approximately equal to 1. Again, draft between front roller and second roller is called as a front zone draft, which would be surface speed of front roller divided by surface speed of second roller, which is 17309 divided by 3077, which would be 5.62. Coming to the middle zone draft, which is a draft between second roller and third roller, it is surface speed of second roller divided by second surface speed of third roller, that is 3077 divided by 3385, which comes to 0.91. The back zone draft, it is a draft between third roller and back roller. So this is surface speed of third roller divided by surface speed of back roller, which is 3385 divided by 2286, which you get as 1.48. So these are the various draft values in the front zone, the middle zone, and the back zone of the drafting system. How do we get the total draft? Total draft in this drafting system, that is front, middle, and back, whatever draft is there, if we multiply them with each other, that means the product of these values would be the total draft. The total draft in the drafting system is 1.48 into, that is 1.48 into 0.91 into 5.62, which is 7.57. Now we come to a small but important topic where we need to calculate the draft constant. We need to calculate this for a reason which I will explain in the next lecture. Today we will only learn how to calculate the draft constant. So what do we mean by draft constant? Draft constant is draft when CP is equal is 1/10. Now we saw in the gearing diagram that there was this TDC or CP which was shown as 40/10. So while calculating draft, if we consider CP as 1/10, then whatever answer we get for draft, that is actually draft constant. So let us see. Draft formula is, we already know, surface speed of front roller upon surface speed of back roller. As per this gearing diagram, let us see how to calculate this. If we see here, draft is equal to pi into d, diameter of the front roller, into RPM of the front roller, which we have already seen how to calculate. So I have just taken those values here, divided by surface speed of back roller, which is pi into diameter of the back roller into the RPM of the back roller, which we have earlier calculated. So if you take this entire formula and we replace this TDC by 1, and this N is the, of course, is the motor RPM, then we get a certain value here to this particular equation, and that value is 302.87. So this is how we calculate draft constant. This 302.87 is a value of draft constant for this particular machine. So the usefulness or the where this draft constant is going to be useful to us in the future, that I will explain in the coming lecture. Okay, so this is all for today. What I want you to do is try and practice how to calculate draft, etc., on your own. Maybe I will give you some problems related to it where you will be able to solve and gain a little confidence on calculating these draft values. Thank you.